My name's John, easytab.com, and this is a quick introduction to the EasyTab point of sale system. EasyTab really is designed for bars and restaurants, either quick service or table service restaurants, bar grill type environment. Any place where you sell food, EasyTab works really well. EasyTab's strengths are the fact that it's very, very simple to use, requiring almost no product training. Comes with a two-page manual. It's so easy. You really need no instructions at all. All the operations are very obvious. It's great for sharing tabs, bar tabs, tables. If you've got more than one device, you can open a table on one device, add to that order on a server station. And the system supports tablets as well, so you can use tablets for table side ordering or ordering in a patio area. So I'm going to just jump in and show you all the operations. We can do a quick service sale. We can go into orders, open up an existing tab or start a new order, and we can choose a server. Multiple servers can use the machine. I'm going to hit server and I'm going to choose John, and I got a PIN number set for me. You don't have to have a password or a PIN number, but I got one set at the moment. I'm just going to put my PIN number in, and I'm going to do a quick service sale. So I'm just going to hit start. This is our main sales screen. At the moment, we're set up for three completely separate menus. So we've got a drinks menu, we've got a foods menu, and we've got a third menu with just extras on there. That third menu can be used for anything. You know, if you have a separate lunchtime menu, a breakfast menu, or even a wine list. So three basic menus to start with. You can add more menus. You can have up to five completely separate menus, but most people, three is enough. In fact, more than enough. You know, sometimes two, just food and drink is plenty. Now within each of those menus, you can have up to 10 different sections. So at the moment, on drinks, you know, these are my drinks sections. If I click on food, the sections will change. And if I click on the extras menu, they'll change again. So I'll start off with the drinks menu. I'll just take a regular soda. This is simplest transaction. Hit the button, sells the item. You can add modifiers. Sides, modifiers probably more for drinks, sides, extra items that you would add on food. To demonstrate that, I'll come to beer and I'll hit bottles, and you can see it prompts us for different size, different beers. So I'll go with the Modelo. So we got sides and options and modifiers. As you enter the items, you've got a audit roll on the side. You've got a running total, and to close out on the transaction, hit the pay button. And we've got two main methods of payment. We can add a third if needed, but our main methods are cash and card. The card button can be used side by side with a separate card terminal unconnected. We do have the option to actually link a card terminal direct to the system, an integrated link, which makes things run a little bit smoother. We currently integrate to PAX devices. We are looking at other devices all the time, but currently the PAX EFT terminals we can integrate into. So I'm just going to hit cash at the moment. I can also, as a shortcut, hit one of these bill buttons. So if somebody gives me a $10 bill, I just hit the $10 button. And that'll finish the transaction off. Leave me the total on the screen, how much was paid and how much changed. And if I want to print a receipt, I can hit the print button, or I can just hit next and go to the next save. So that's a very typical quick service. I'm now going to go into orders. So I'm going to hit my order screen. And this will show any orders that are on there. Also show closed out tickets as well. So there's the cash transaction that I just did. It's showing that I've got no orders open at the moment. So I'm going to open a new tab. So I'm going to hit the new button. And it's going to be a table. I'm just going to use a simple number. It's going to be table number one. I'm going to hit OK. That takes us back again to our sales screen. So I can pull up a drink. I'm going to go for a drink first. I'm going to add a Diet Coke on there as well. Now I'm not going to do anything more than this. I'm just going to save it away. I'm going to hit the save button because I put some drinks and I'm going to come back and add some food to the order in just a second. So I'm going to hit save. What will happen is that transaction is saved away, and I can pick that up on any terminal. If you've got more than one terminal, all the tabs can be shared, so I can pick that up on a second terminal. So I'm just gonna pretend that I've just gone, you know, taken a food order now, so I'm gonna bring orders back up. It's showing my orders. You can bring the orders up for everyone, but the default is that it will only show you your own orders, whichever server's using the machine. So there's table number one. This is a countdown time. It tells me that the table's been open for 1 minute, so I can just basically see how long the table's been active. And I'm going to add some food items. So I'm going to click on the food button, and I've got these different groups on here, and I'm going to go for like a quesadilla. So I'm going to hit the quesadilla button. With the food, I've got lots of modifiers, lots of options. For instance, if I want no salad, I can hit the no salad key, no tomato, no jalapeno. So there's just three options. This is a multi-side. Multi-side means you can pick more than one option. And you can use it to add things or remove things. Either way is good. So I'm going to hit OK. So here's my food items on there now. Again, I'm just going to save that away. Now, the system does support kitchen and bar printers. You can have up to four printers. Usually people have, you know, one bar for the kitchen. One printer for the kitchen. But you can have more than one printer if you maybe have a section that does desserts and a section that does the entrees. You can split things. Each item can be assigned to a different printer. So if I was to hit save now and I had a kitchen order printer, that order would go to the kitchen. We'd have the table number on there, the server name, the time, and the food items on there. The drinks wouldn't go because I wouldn't set the drinks up to print them on. You can if you want, but normally you would just set the food items to print on the kitchen order printer. That would go to the kitchen. I can pull that transaction back again, click into orders, bring the table up. You can add multiple items, and each time you add items to the order and save it, it will only print out new items that you've added to the order. Again, if we had a bar printer on the bar, it would print the drinks out to the bar printer. But you can add multiple things. To close out the bill, you would first want to print. So you'd hit the print button, you get a nice printed receipt on the printer. Present that, obviously, to the table. And then once you get the check back to finalise the transaction, just like the quick service, you go to pay. And you've got cash or card, so I'm going to just do this one with cash, and I'm going to say that they gave us $20. Okay, so that is a typical table transaction, and again, if we go in there, we'll see that both orders are in there closed out. That's the basics of the system. It's very easy, very, very simple to use, very easy to program. I'll quickly go through some of the programming options that are on there. Programming is done by hitting the programming button here. I do need to change operators because at the moment I it's password protected. I don't have the ability to use that. I could put the password in, but just as easy, I'm going to change to the manager, and I put my manager code in there. Okay, now because I'm a manager and I've got programming options, I got access to the settings. I also got access to actually item programming. So I can hit the start button, and then I got my sales screen as usual, but just as an easy way of changing things, if I wanted to change the price of Coke, I can hit the program button. You can see it's $2.25, so I can hit that on there, and I'm just going to change that to $2.50. And it really is as easy as that to change things. You know, let's change that. Instead of that being tea, let's call that hot tea. And we'll do that for $3.50. So programming is very, very, very easy to use. Modifiers, we can add modifiers. Let's have a look at, let's go to drinks. Let's go to beer. And let's have a look at bottle. Now bottle is set up with a modifier. So if we hit the bottle, I'm gonna hit edit because this shows you. And basically, these are all the modifiers that are on here at the moment. You can have like up to 100 different modifiers. And those modifiers can have, you know, virtually unlimited number of prompts that are on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly look at my options for bottles. So when I hit the bottles button, it asks us, you know, to choose from Corona, Corona Lights. you can see all these options. The price is in with each one, so each different modifier has a price. And we got three types of modifiers. We got the main modifier itself, which changes an item. We've got a side, which adds an additional item. So if you're, you know, buying a meal, that might come with an option to have fries or wedges. And then we've got multi-sides. So multi-sides are, again, if you're ordering a pizza, the multi-sides are the toppings that you choose, and you can choose more than one. So it would prompt you can choose the different toppings that you want on there. So the whole thing, very, very easy. Very easy to set up, very easy to program. I'm just going to click OK. And you can jump, because I'm a manager, I can jump in and out of programming. And then the other things I would want to do to set the system up, I'm going to go into the programming button. I got a config page where I can set things like the tax rates, set up the printers that I'm using, up to four different kitchen printers. If I'm doing integrated card services, I can set the option up for the card terminal. And I can change the name and address on the receipt. I can change the main group buttons. And I can also set up a floor plan as well for ordering if you want to set up a floor plan. Let me just go back to the configuration, and I can show you how we can do that. The other thing you want to change is your operators. So we hit cashiers. These are the different operators that are on there. And each operator, you can decide what level of security you want to give them. So for instance, manager, you can tick the boxes to allow the manager access to pretty much everything. So they can change the menu, they can do readings, they can change the settings, they're allowed to do voids. They can bring up the final Z cash total at the end of the night. You can choose whether a cashier or a server is kept in, or whether they have to sign in for each transaction. You can also allow certain servers to not be able to close out, so they can only take the order. That's used mostly if you're in a situation where you have a cashier's terminal where all the payments are taken. You can set a password on there, and you can choose an icon for the operator as well. Okay, so you can also set food options up here and the item menu from here. There's a backup option to back up your data. There's an option to set the time zone, and there's an option for remote desktop support as well. One of the nice things about this system is that, you know, if you do need help or your client needs help setting things up, we can do a desk share, we can connect into the screen, we can show you how to do things, we can set buttons up for you, we can walk you through doing certain things. So just like us being there, or works through the internet. So that's pretty much it. As terms as readings are concerned, oh, we got a time clock on there, so employees can clock in and clock out. We've got a basic report per individual cashier. And we've got a Z report at the end of the day, which I'll click on. And that'll give you a breakdown of basically cash, what cash is in the drawer, the different tax amounts. If there's card sales, we'd have a breakdown of card sales as well. Servers, so there's me, John. I just done a couple of transactions. The product sales, so we can see the individual items that we've seen. The sales department, so if you just want a breakdown of each different sales group, we can do. And you can actually list the individual orders if you want to see the orders, and also see if there's any orders that are open. And you can fine-tune this report. So for instance, if you don't want to see the items, you can just unclick that tick box. And if you don't want to see the orders, and you don't want to see the servers, and you don't want to see the open sales, you can get just a very basic report. So you can home in on the level of detail that you want to see. This is the report you would do at the end of the night. You can do it during the day. You can print it without zeroing it. At the end of the night, you would do a print and zero. That would zero the report so that everything starts again the next day. So hope you enjoyed the demonstration. If you need any more information, you can just go to our webpage, easytab.com, and give us a call. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed.